Hi everyone, we learnt all forms of verbs as far as present tense and past tense are concerned. Now we have to learn future tense. When do we use it and what are the structures of it? How to frame sentences? Let us know about it with examples. Now let us know what does future denote and when do we use it. Normally, suppose if we want to make any plans, what do we use? Future tense, because those actions are going to take place in future. When you are making any schedule, then we use future tense. Now let us see the structure of.
We find all four forms in future tense also. The structure of simple future is subject, will or shall, verb. That is verb V1 we call, plus object. Here we use the auxiliary verb will or shall, which denotes future. If you take the example, I shall meet you tomorrow. Normally in first person we use shall and second and third persons we use will. Anyway, will or shall, no problem. I shall meet you tomorrow. Tomorrow is the keyword which indicates the action which is going to take place in future. So here tomorrow is the keyword. Now when do we use future continuous? Normally if you do compare to study, you can have better understanding of it. We learnt about present continuous. So action which is going on at present, we use present continuous. Action which was going on in the past, at this moment we use past continuous. When action which is going to take place in future at this point of time, then we use future continuous tense. What is the structure for it? Subject, will or shall, plus be. We use be forms. In be forms we have be also, so only be, and ing form of verb, that is present participle form of verb, and then object and all. So if you take the example, they will be writing test tomorrow at this moment. Here we have to take the phrase at this moment also. Both the words are needed here. Tomorrow is needed, at this moment. These two are the keywords which tells us the tense form here which we have to use is future continuous tense. They will be writing test tomorrow at this moment. Now future perfect tense. When do we use future perfect tense and what is the structure of it? See, suppose if you are going to finish some work and you are giving assurance that work will be completed in future only, and at the same time you are giving assurance that you will complete the work in given period of time, right? In such cases you have to use future perfect tense. What is the structure of it? Subject, will or shall, then have, then past participle form of verb, that is V3, and then object. We shall have completed our project by next month. So here we are giving assurance some project is going to be finished and that will be finished in future and in given period of time, that is by next month. By next month is the keyword which indicates that you have to use future perfect tense. The students will have written their board examinations by the next year. So in that way we have to use future perfect tense. That is the structure of it. Then comes future perfect continuous tense. When do we use it? See, the work is going to take place in future and it will continue in future in a period of time. Then we use future perfect continuous tense. Every time you take the comparative study, when you take the comparative study, then you can have better understanding of it. Present perfect continuous, past perfect continuous, and future perfect continuous, so that you will know even the structures and how to use it. When do we use it? We will know all these things. So here in future perfect continuous, what do we have? Subject, will or shall, have and been. Then present participle form of verb, then object. And the example of this is, they will have been staying in Hyderabad for the next 2 weeks. So here period of time is given. The keywords for future perfect continuous tense are for the next 2 weeks. In future perfect, we use the work will be completed by given period of time. But in future perfect continuous, the work will start in future and will be continuing also in future for that given period of time. Don't get confused by this. If you continuously do the exercises, you will have better understanding of it. And application is always important. While talking, while writing any reports, while writing any notes. So you have to develop all these skills. Tense is very, very important. That is why we stressed on tense. Doing practice is very, very important to get command over English. So grammar plays very important role. For intermediate students, 5 marks are allotted for these verb forms, and even in correction of sentences also, some 5 marks are allotted for correction of sentences. So it is always, not only in examination point of view, for developing your speaking skills, these tenses are very, very important.